Bonjour, ici Olivier Roland, bienvenue dans cette nouvelle vidéo de Blogueur Pro. Donc je suis actuellement avec JB. Hello JB.
Hello, hello my brother, how are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Awesome.
on va faire le reste de l'interview en anglais parce que JB parle pas français, donc surtout pensez bien à activer les sous-titres, hein, il y a un bouton pour activer ça dans YouTube si ça s'affiche pas par défaut. So JB, I wanted to interview you because you are quite famous in the US for your awesome podcast, Morning Coach.
Yes, we've done pretty good with it.
Yeah, I love this podcast because you have so much energy. Can you say a good morning for us,
please? Yeah, good morning!
And so, yeah, you have a lot of success right now in the US with that. Your business model is that you have a free podcast every Monday.
Yes.
That's right.
They call it kind of
a freemium
model. Yeah, so free Monday. And then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, you have to pay $20 a month to get the rest of it.
Okay, so yeah, all right.
And we're testing pricing, so it might be a little bit higher.
Yeah,
we're going to go.
So far, the price is a bit low, I mean.
Yes, it's really low. But yeah. We won't go there.
Yeah, we won't go there. But yeah, I love the podcast. It's full of energy and good content. And how many customers do you have right now?
We have a few thousand paid customers. In the last couple of years that we've done it, we've had 7,000 people sign up. And so we get anywhere from 200 or so to stick with us, and then we lose 50 to 100, depending on, you know, what's going on in people's lives. So we're growing every month.
Wow. And now, it's a way you put your main content. You publish your main content with this podcast. You don't have a blog or videos. You're just starting, like, videos.
I'm just starting. And what happened was I really was narrow focused on the podcast, made that a winner, you know, and now I'm starting to go into other mediums, which then drives traffic to make the business bigger.
So, all right. So the subject of the video today is how to make a great podcast.
I love it.
Because a great podcast can be a great asset for a blog or for an entrepreneur on internet.
Agreed. And I think people underestimate it.
Yeah.
And the reason is because they say, oh, it's just some audio thing. Why don't I do some video like this when I should be, you know, when it's, the video will be more, you know, it'll work better. A lot of people think that. But at the end of the day, the thing with the podcast, why people should podcast, is it creates intimacy. People are listening to you. The other point that I like to make about podcasting is this, that people can take it with them. So they're not having to sit and watch a video like we're doing. They actually can put the earphones on and go to the gym or go for a walk.
Exactly.
Yeah, so a podcast is a great medium that I think a lot of people don't really see the value.
Yeah.
They underestimate it totally.
Yeah, so yeah, intimacy, and you can listen to it when you drive, when you do some sport. When you cook,
yeah.
Every time you do something that not involve your brain,
and you're not asking somebody to invest their time specifically in you, okay?
Exactly.
So they can go and do other things and be listening to you. So first step.
It's very interesting because it's a medium that have the ability to reach people that will not have the time.
Yes,
to be rich.
Exactly, and everybody's busy, so that's why. And that's why I didn't go into video. Everybody's like, well, why don't you just do video podcasts? Well, because then somebody's driving their car watching the video. That's not a good thing, you know. If they're listening to me, it works out even better. So
yeah.
that's the secret, really, of podcasting. Plus, the other thing is the intimacy with the listener. Like, you're in their ears one-on-one. And a great podcast, just to give you a tip, we'll go into that, but is that you're speaking to one person. Like a video, one person's watching, but we really have a lot of eyeballs, right? With a podcast, for sure, it's one person. So you don't want to be saying all of you and everyone. You want to say, how are you doing today? I hope you're doing great. Good morning.
So do you imagine you are talking to your best friend?
Yeah, I always do. I have an avatar. And depending on what podcast I'm doing, whether I got a coaching one for business and personal development, I see that avatar, and I really see them in a bad position, maybe depressed, maybe not feeling good, and I speak to that avatar.
Awesome.
Yeah, and it works real well.
So it's already a good tip to make great podcasts, but another reason to do a podcast is that there are less competitors, I think.
What
do you think? Than in YouTube, for example.
Oh, yeah. There's very few competitors. I mean, you can be a rock star in that space. I mean, that's what's happening to me is that, you know, I was in this space, and I'm no longer a podcaster. You know, but when I started, I was kind of a podcaster, you know, and I was in that space. But now I'm finally getting to where I am, a motivational speaker, an author, a coach, you know, and it's scaling my business gigantic, and podcasting was just a tool. Does that make sense?
Yeah,
so,
totally.
Yeah, you know what I mean? So I was a kind of labeled a podcaster at one point, but now it's like, no, he's not a podcaster. It's his podcast.
All right. So, okay. And, okay, so now we know why we should do a podcast. So
yes.
Can you give us some tips to make great podcasts, like awesome podcasts?
Yeah, I think, again, you can't overproduce it, because people want to hear the ums and the ahs, and they want to know you're real.
Exactly. So, yes. You don't want to sound like a robot.
No, and you want to be as authentic as possible. So you want to have like a conversation. Again, it's a one-on-one deal. So
like we do now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I think so many people try to overproduce. They worry about the music and the intro and all that other stuff, when you don't need any of that. My first podcast didn't even have intros or anything. I just hit record and at the end, stop and put it up.
Really?
Yeah, and those were actually really popular. And I used to get feedback like, I'm so glad you're just not this over-commercialized junk.
Interesting. Yeah. So it is a way of positioning yourself differently than the competition.
Yeah, so I would say...
You're not a radio.
Yeah, yeah. Now I do some music at the front and back, but it's still unedited. I mean, I'll make a mistake and have problems, but I just run with it. So I would say, you know, you just want to have a conversation with somebody. So I outline and then just have a conversation, you know, 4 or 5 points, and that's a good podcast.
It is huge, because I think a lot of people are too perfectionist, you know?
100%.
They want to have the perfect podcast before publishing it, and the problem is 2 years after, they have the perfect podcast in their computer, and that's all.
100%. And you know what? And it took me 500 before I made a dime. So while people were trying to perfect it, I was doing them and getting better and better and better, you know? And yeah, I was getting the complaints when I was at 100, and then 101 day and 102 days, but every day I got a little bit better. So while I was doing it, all my competitors were trying to be perfect, and oh, I only do one a week, and I was like, no, I'm just going to do it.
Exactly.
Yes, and that's what a great, well, you'll become a great podcaster once you've done 1,800. Well, actually, I'm like 2,100 now total.
Wow. Yeah, so it was really impressive for me when I met you the first time, because you said, hey, I'm creating a podcast every single day of the work week.
Yep. So Monday through Friday. Monday to Friday. Yeah, because we need the weekends.
I mean, yeah. Come on. Okay, so from Monday to Friday, whatever happens, wherever you are in the world, it doesn't matter, right?
Yep, nope.
You have your hardware with you.
Yep, and that's another thing that's great about audio. All I need is a mic and a Mac, and I'm good to go.
So do you edit it a lot, or it's just like you?
There is no editing allowed on my podcast. No, no editing. I do it, literally, it's a 15-minute podcast. I'm done in 20 minutes. So my work day, you know, is get up. I don't shower. I have a little too much information, but I jump out of bed.
Right.
I go down into my office. I outline my first podcast. I outline the second podcast. Takes me about 10 minutes.
Okay.
I then put those two pieces of paper. I put my microphone up. It's already set up. And I just go into GarageBand, what I use, and I hit record. And I just run for 15 minutes, hit stop.
Awesome.
Put music on the front and the back, save to my computer. Go back in the GarageBand, do the next one.
Okay.
Get done with that. That's usually 5 to 10 minutes. Put a little front and back on that. Put it to my computer. So that's, let's say that's 7 o'clock in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
It's now 7:35.
Wow.
I put it up on my website, and I'm done for the day.
My God. So you create 2 podcasts a day?
Yes, I do. I'm doing 2 a day.
All right.
So then I'm done. It's like 8 o'clock. Well, 7:30. So I go up, shower, have some breakfast, and say, what am I going to do today?
It's a good problem.
Yeah, exactly. So now I'm doing video and stuff now, because I got some time during the day.
Yeah, did you do that since the beginning? I mean, just press record and be done?
Since the beginning.
Wow.
Yeah. And originally, what was crazy is, this is why you just do it. When I originally started, I used to do it on the phone because I didn't even know how to record in a computer. And I used to use freeconferencecall.com, which here in the States is a conference line. Mm-hmm. And I would record and people would call in and listen to the recording. This is a true story. For 2 days or 3 days in a row, I would be recording the podcast and somebody else on another line I didn't know how to mute.
Oh, really?
You would hear this guy in the background go, tink, and then this stream, and then this flush. And it was on my podcast. And then I get all these emails like, JB, the guy's going to the bathroom again. And that's how I got my start. It's like, that's how bad it was. And people still listen. And so obviously I learned how to mute, you know, but that's the true story. I mean, that's why it's like, you just got to build your audience and do it every day. So yeah, I've always not edited. You know, I've gotten better at it. When you do 2,000, you know, that comes from, you know, 10,000 hours thing. You get better at things. But my suggestion to do a great podcast is just be authentic, Just be real. People understand there's mistakes. If there's
it makes you more human.
Yes. If something happens in the background, mistakes make you more human. And people appreciate that. So if something happens in the background, you know, the dishes clank or something, and you're not in the studio, just say, hey, I'm sorry, you know, the dishes clanked in the background. Let people know.
No editing.
No, no editing. Why edit? Yeah. That takes time away from other things.
Like playing golf.
Or whatever. Whatever we're going to do. YouTube videos or creating products or whatever. So, yeah, it's unnecessary. I think we call it diminishing returns, mm-hmm. where you do something and you try to become so perfect that even if you polished it that extra 20%, you may only get a 1% gain. Or it may give you no gain. So it's really a diminishing return to go back and edit it all. Now, there may be some circumstances if you're producing a professional show for some TV program.
Yeah, but we're not talking about that.
No, we're not talking about
that. We're talking about a human podcast designed by humans for humans.
Correct. That works.
That's wrong.
It works. It builds an audience, which I've done a pretty good job with. So anybody can do it. I believe that in my heart that there's millions of people in the world and everybody has a story to tell. You just got to start doing it and build your story. That's what I would suggest.
All right. And so how about the energy? Because you have a lot of energy.
Yes.
Because you have a secret for that, or is it just natural?
That's one of my gifts, is that I've always had energy. But you need to take care of yourself. You need to eat right. You need to, if you don't do that.
Do some sport.
Yeah, you can't, I mean, I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, you know, you can't have a half a bottle of scotch the night before and then get up and try to do a podcast every day, you know?
But you did that, right?
Yeah, I
can feel it. I've had some experience, right?
Yeah, I've had a few. Well, when you do 2,000, there are a couple of those days where the night before it kind of carried over. But if you're going to have the good energy, I'm going to have some flops in there. I mean, it just is what it is. And you're going to have things. You're going to be sick or not feel good. And you just got to work through those. People understand. And the other thing is, if you're making content for people that don't respect you as a human being, mm-hmm. those are horrible customers anyways.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because they're going to give you a hard time. They're going to write bad comments. So get people that respect you for you and appreciate the issues that you have, because then when you have an issue, they respect you and you don't have to deal with the BS.
Yeah, don't be afraid of, frying.
Yes.
A bad reader, a bad customer.
Yeah, get rid of them, fire them.
Yeah. I mean, life is short, you don't have time for that.
No, and there's millions of people. Every single person that's watching this video, I'm sure, has a circle of 100,000 people that they could get around, let's say, over the next 5 years. And if you got 100,000 people listening to you, they're going to buy your products, they're going to support you. Heck, even if you ask for a donation of $1 each, that's six figures a year.
Exactly.
It works.
Yeah, you have a six-figure business right now.
Yes.
You're making like 600,000?
Yes, yes. It's
just
growing.
Just with podcast.
Yes, just with podcast.
We're working.
Yes, no sales.
Yeah, to create products.
Yeah, no. And a very low price point at that.
But it's working because you create really good content.
Yes.
That people love. You have great energy.
It's all about the content.
And you do a podcast
every day. And if the technology is bad or something and it doesn't work, boy, you don't want it be in my emails. Where are you at today? Why isn't this working?
Whoa.
So it's they
you
want
have really
it.
A hungry crowd. Yeah,
a hungry crowd. We're together. We're a community. We've built. We now have 90,000 people on Facebook. The podcast has been the springboard to community, mm-hmm. and so that's allowed us to build. You know, we have 10,000 on Twitter. I only follow 400 people, but that's still a nice community of people that are working together in social platforms to put good energy out there.
Right. So what about the habit? How did you create this habit of doing one podcast a day? Because for a lot of people, I think it's simple.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's difficult because it's only like 30 minutes of work a day.
Yeah, yeah. But at the beginning, it was a little more because I had to get it down. But yeah, it's just like, look, when I teach people to do something, it's like you have to do it. Like you either do it or you don't. You know, there's an old story about when the Spaniards came to Mexico to fight the Indians, that mm-hmm. they burnt the boats, so they couldn't go back. And you're either going to do it or you don't. Either do it every day or don't do it. And for me, I knew it was my business. And so it's like I have to do this every day. And it just, I mean, I could roll over in bed and do it now if I had to. But it had to be done on a daily basis because that's the only way to be successful. Weekly is too much of a disconnect.
Well, I think a great insight you just gave us is that you can just walk 30 minutes a day if
and it can create great, great results for you on your business. So I don't know, if you have a bad habit right now, like, I don't know, you spend 30 minutes a day on TV, or you just watched 30 minutes a day on Facebook, or, you know, anything like that, you can replace this bad habit but by a good habit that will help you advance throughout your goals.
Correct.
And at the end, I mean, in 1 year, 2 years, it will make a big, big difference. Yeah. Just the 30 minutes 100%. A day. I got, it is a gift. You are giving right now. I mean,
it's
realization.
And honestly, it's very selfish for me because my life has changed by doing it. Because I have to be the one that's disciplined to listen to the message, come up with the message, and being the teacher, sometimes you learn things even better. So my life has transformed totally. So it's been a gift to me. So even without all the listeners and the growth of the business, the growth that's occurred for me doing a podcast every day has totally changed my life.
Wow. So it's selfish and it's great for you, and you still help people at the same time. Awesome,
it's
right?
It's like a total win-win.
It's the dream job.
It is. It is. It works real well, and I sleep good at night because I'm putting good energy out there.
Exactly. So thank you. To finish the interview, do you have a tip to give to you know, beginners that want to start the podcast right now?
Yeah. You know, it took me – this is really critical. It took me 2 years to make money. Mm-hmm. 2 years of sacrifice, pain. Is this going to work? I almost quit 20 times,
wow.
Self-doubt, you know, this, I only got 3 people listening, this sucks, you know, you know, the guy going to the bathroom in the background, the complaints, the technology not working, you just got to do it, and you got to stick with it. You can't quit at 100, you can't quit at 200, you can't quit at 500, you got to get to 1,000, and if you do that, it'll work. It'll work.
Well, so if you still are watching this video, I think it's because you are motivated by that. So please take at least one action you will do from this video. Okay, just don't do something, because if you just say, okay, I watch it, it's great, you will not advance toward your goal. So take one action and do it, please. So thank you, GB, for everything. It was
thank
awesome.
Thank you, brother. Great to be on here.
See you soon.
Bye. Ciao, everybody.